Batteries, the invention that powers most of the modern world. Many electronics you enjoy using won't work without them. These include your phone, laptop, tablet, and the electric car in your garage. Some satellites also use batteries out there in orbit. However, these batteries have limitations that affect the level of satisfaction we can derive from them. This is why scientists have been working hard at creating a new battery. The latest result is a diamond battery that has the potential to last for thousands of years and also help eliminate nuclear waste. How does the diamond battery last so long, and how does it work? Join us as we bring you scientists' insane new diamond batteries just released. The best battery with ability for a wide range of applications is the lithium-ion battery. You are probably watching this video on a device powered by a lithium-ion battery. If you drive an electric car, then you have lithium-ion batteries to thank for it. Similarly, many battery energy storage systems use lithium-ion batteries to warehouse electricity to be supplied on demand. Lithium-ion batteries replace the lead-acid battery, especially in intensive applications, because of their many benefits. However, lithium-ion batteries still have their limitations, and these hold back many advances we could have made as a human race. For example, lithium-ion cells and batteries are not as robust as some other rechargeable technologies. They require protection from being overcharged and discharged too far. In addition to this, they need to have the current maintained within safe limits. Accordingly, one lithium-ion battery disadvantage is that they require protection circuitry incorporated to ensure they are kept within their safe operating limits. Adding these safety measures increases the weight of the battery and cost. It also makes maintenance and disposal more difficult. Another major disadvantage of lithium-ion batteries for consumer electronics is that the batteries suffer from aging. Not only is this time or calendar dependent, but it is also dependent upon the number of charge-discharge cycles that the battery has undergone. Often batteries will only be able to withstand between 500 and 1000 charge-discharge cycles before their capacity falls. With the development of lithium-ion technology, this figure is increasing, but after a while, batteries may need replacing, and this can be an issue if they are embedded in the equipment. Lithium-ion batteries age whether they are in use or not, meaning despite the degree of usage, there is a time-related element to the reduction in capacity. Lithium-ion batteries also have a transportation problem. Many airlines limit the number of lithium-ion batteries they take, which means their transportation is limited to ships. Air travelers often need to carry their lithium-ion batteries in carry-on luggage. Any lithium-ion batteries carried separately must be protected against short circuits by protective covers. It is particularly important with some of the large lithium-ion batteries, like those used in large power banks. There is also the big issue of costs. This is most obvious when it comes to electric cars. About one-third of the sticker price goes to the battery for any EV you buy, making EVs significantly more expensive than their ICE counterparts. In fact, a basic EV may cost the same as a luxury ICE. Lithium-ion also has some restrictions on how they can be used. For example, to gain the best from lithium-ion cells and batteries, it is wise not to charge or discharge the cells and batteries fully. Running the cells and batteries between 20 and 80% has been quoted as the optimal regime. Some battery management systems may ensure that the cells are never fully charged or discharged. The levels they indicate may already have this taken into account. Lithium-ion cells and batteries do not like being fully discharged, and they also do not like being fully charged. This is because in either state, all the lithium ions will be removed from one electrode or the other, and this causes the electrode to disintegrate more quickly. Also, lithium-ion batteries do not work well in the cold, like where snow falls. For electric vehicles, the driving range becomes significantly reduced the lower the temperature gets. For these reasons, humanity needs a better battery, and scientists have been working to provide just that. The result is the diamond battery, which promises to change the world completely. One of the companies involved in diamond battery technology is NDB, a startup based in California. It's announced its new nano diamond battery, but other people call it the nuclear diamond battery. NDB uses technology made from nuclear waste encased in artificial diamond. The nano diamond battery has an incredible maximum lifespan of 28,000 years. That is like eternity when it comes to battery life or anything else. The new battery could one day become a source of low-carbon power for anything that needs it, from planes to smartphones. The idea of a nuclear diamond battery was first developed and presented by scientists at the University of Bristol in 2016. In a lecture, Professor Tom Scott explained that his team had grown a synthetic diamond that can generate a small electric current when placed in a radioactive field. The resulting battery is effectively self-charging in that the diamond can produce a charge when it is placed close to a radioactive source. The Bristol team initially demonstrated a prototype that used nickel-63 as the radiation source, although they later chose to utilize carbon-14, a radioactive version of carbon. And that is one of the benefits of nuclear diamond batteries. They will help clean up nuclear wastes. The UK's aging nuclear power plants contain huge reserves of carbon-14 within the graphite blocks in their reactors. Although carbon-14 is a low-yield beta particle emitter, it's still too risky to allow it into the environment, and therefore it must be stored securely for the long term. The scientists at Bristol see a valuable opportunity in extracting and repurposing what is at present purely a nuclear waste material. Last year, a spin-off company called Arcanlight was formed to take on the commercialization of the diamond battery concept. Using nuclear waste this way is far better than burying them deep in the ground, where special care has to be taken to prevent contamination. Meanwhile, many people squirm at the mention of nuclear materials because of the fear of radiation. However, nuclear diamond batteries are not dangerous. The diamond battery is a beta voltaic, which is similar to a photovoltaic solar cell, only that it converts beta radiation instead of light into electricity. It's manufactured through chemical vapor deposition using C14, methane, and hydrogen plasma to grow diamond films at high temperatures. The diamond used in the battery consists of thin layers of large crystalline grains, so it's far smaller than the diamond found on rings. This multi-layer structure is also designed to prevent radiation leakage and minimize the danger to human health. Carbon-14 beta particles, though energetic, don't travel very far. If you have it safely ensconced in a dense matrix such as diamond, then the likelihood that it would emit radiation in a way that would penetrate human skin becomes negligible. While NDB is focusing on heavy-duty applications like electric vehicles, Arcanlight is looking to power small detectors, wireless IoT devices, sensors, or medical implants with nuclear diamond batteries. The company views the diamond battery as an enabling technology, meaning that it might spur the development of applications that wouldn't have been possible without it. Bristol researchers have tested the strength and durability of their diamond batteries at the top of a volcano. In the experiment, prototype Arcanlight beta voltaics were used to power sensors inside a remote monitoring station known as a Dragon Egg. The eggs are designed to be delivered to an active volcano by drone, where they keep track of humidity, vibrations, and the emissions of toxic gases. The diamond's indelible nature also means that nuclear diamond batteries may one day assist in distributed power management for satellites or spacecraft, allowing them to lead longer operational lives in extreme environments. A good candidate is the JWST, which has a lifespan of 2 decades due to the amount of fuel on board. With nuclear diamond batteries, the Space Observation Station can continue to deliver stunning pictures that help us know more about the universe for eternity. With the world increasingly dependent on sensor input, Arcanlight's batteries could provide a fit-and-forget solution that enables the widespread rollout of IoT devices. According to Morgan Boardman, CEO of Arcanlight, the technology also offers attractive emission savings. With the resources used to manufacture, say, a AAA battery, we would offset nearly 2.5 kilograms of carbon in manufacturing an equivalent energy density of diamond batteries. Arcanlight aims to establish a factory at one of several decommissioned nuclear power plants in the southwest of England, or possibly North Wales. That way, the company has easy access to carbon-14 isotopes for battery manufacturing. Boardman estimates that, all being well, the carbon-14 batteries will begin appearing in devices as soon as 2024. Let's hear what you think of nuclear diamond batteries in the comments section below.